All right. Hi. So let's start the thermal chemistry today. So let me just go to the down. So I post this worksheet in on the blackboard. So before you do this, make sure you watch read all the textbook, and then come back to this one. And you should probably watch these videos because this video might actually explain what I think it's important for this chapter and pinpoint that some important topic in this thermal chemistry topic. So let me just go to that one. Alright, so the thermal chemistry, right? The thermal chemistry is a study of the energy flow. So you can actually transfer energies by doing the chemical reactions. So that's really the thermal chemistry. So there are two types of energies. One is called the kinetic energies that's associated with the motion of the particle. And then the other one is actually called potential energies. That can be electrostatic potential, which is really important for the thermal chemistry. And nobody cares about this gravitational stuff if you're a chemist. So chemists and biologists, they all care about this electrostatic potential. So electrostatic potential is usually given by this formula, which is Coulomb equations, called the Coulomb potential. The electrostatic energy is proportional to the charge of the particle multiplied by the charge of another particle divided by the distance in between those two. So you are going to deal with this potential energies quite often in the field of chemistry or the biology. So let's start out with the kinetic energies. The kinetic energies is given by 1/2 mv squared or mu squared. U is the velocity or speed. So as you increase the speed, kinetic energy increase. As you increase the mass, kinetic energy increase. So that's a formula that I want you to memorize. And then the other one is the potential energies for this particular case. We are talking about this electrostatic potential. And electrostatic potential can actually change by changing the location of atoms respectively. So that if you change the position of the atoms, then the potential energy changes. So by making the water molecule like the bent structures, that will minimize the potential energies. And if you try to make the water molecule in the linear structure, then that one right there will have lots of potential energies in there. So everything that's associated with the chemical reactions, we are dealing with these potential energies quite often. So that's super important. So for example, the job of chemist is to actually come up with the reaction which can actually produce energy, and then that energy can be used for our daily life. So for example, like mixing up the hydrogen and oxygen to form the H2O is going to produce a massive amount of energies, quite a lot. So you can actually use this energy to actually go from one place to the other, right? So the goal of chapter 5, or the whatever the chapters in your textbook, is how much energy can I get out of the given chemical reaction, and then also memorize the definitions associated with the thermodynamics. So let's start from the some of the stuff that I think it's kind of important for the thermodynamics. The unit that we use for the energies is joule, and if you decode the kinetic energy is one of those energies, right? The other one is a potential energy. And the kinetic energy is always given by this formula. 1/2 multiplied by the mass times the speed square, right? Mass is usually given by kilogram, and then speed is usually given by meter square, meter per second, right? Meter per second. So if you put it in the 1/2 mv² form, you get the kilogram meter square per second square. And that's the definition of the joule. And if you become a food scientist, then what they use is 1 kcal, which is by definition, it's 4.184 joule. And if you use a capital kcal, uppercase kcal, then that's 1,000 calories, lowercase. So capital letter or the lowercase letters is important. So make sure that the when you actually read the program, is that capital or the lowercase, okay? And as I said, that thermochemistry is the study of the transfer of energies, the heat in this chapter. So the thermochemistry is the study of transfer of energies, so that the energies being heat. For this particular case, then there are two types of heat or the energy transfer, and one is exothermic, so the reaction produce heat, that's exothermic. The exo means going outward, so the exothermic means it produces heat. So the reaction inside of the beaker produces heat, and heat escape from the beaker to heat up the surroundings, and endothermic is the one that absorb heat. So energy is used as an input, right? So the energy is gathered together, going into the beaker, and then you're gonna produce the product molecules, and heat is gone. Heat is actually used, the energy is absorbed to produce the product molecule. So these two is really common terminologies, and all of the scientists use these two terms quite often. So it's important to memorize this. Exothermic, produce heat and going outward, right? Endothermic is the one that absorb heat, okay? So there are two videos associated with this exothermic or endothermic videos. So make sure that you watch these. I put these things on the blackboard. So make sure that you watch and see one is exothermic and then the other one is endothermic reactions. So that's a very fast, quick rundown of the first part of the thermodynamics. I'm going to talk about a little bit more about the thermodynamics stuff in the second videos and third videos.